Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I know that I've been really MIA on YouTube lately. So this is kind of just gonna be a really random video to update you guys on grad school and what's been going on and all of that fun stuff. So for those of you that are new to my channel or in general, I feel like I haven't really discussed my grad school experience or even grad school really at all, other than maybe in one of my vlogs. So I am in my first year of graduate school for speech language pathology, and I'm in my second semester currently. So I'm gonna get into all of that because with this whole coronavirus, things have been all messed up and really crazy. So I just want to briefly go over my last semester. So my first semester was a good semester. I had 3 clients. So at my school, the first year of grad school, we do in clinic hours. So we just have clients the first year in the clinic. We usually have 4 to 5 clients each semester, but I only ended up having 3 last semester just due to scheduling conflicts and things like that. So last semester I had 3 clients and I had 4 classes. So I took language acquisition, I took adult language disorders, I can't even remember, it's so sad. I took articulation and phonology, and then I had my clinical seminar class, which is basically where we just go over clinic and just learn more about working with clients. I think that's all the classes I took last semester. Yeah, it is. Okay, and then I had 3 clients, like I said. Now fast forward to this semester, my second semester. I have 3 clients, diagnostics, which is where basically each week you have a new person come in and you evaluate them, you administer some formal and informal testing and all that stuff. And then I am taking preschool language disorders, dysphagia, language and speech disorders for adults, and then once again my clinical seminar class. So this semester so far was going good. Dysphagia is definitely a very intense and difficult class, but I'm learning a lot. This semester was definitely I don't know which tense to use because now with everything going on it's like okay. This semester is definitely harder than last semester, just a lot more responsibility. The classes are more difficult. You're expected to be more independent with your clients, but overall, I was making it through, but it was going pretty good so far, and we got about halfway through, and this whole coronavirus thing happened. And everything is just crazy right now. So I figured I'd just give you guys a little update about what's going on with my grad program. With the whole coronavirus pandemic happening in the world is a crazy place right now. All in this together, we're all going through this together. So basically, last Wednesday, my school closed and went to online classes. But the clinic, the speech clinic at my school was still open as of last Wednesday. It gets a little confusing. So all of our classes were canceled by the college. We were not allowed to have class, so we got moved to online classes, but the clinic was still allowed to be open. So we were still able to see our clients and have all of that go as it was before. It was just our classes were just gonna be online. But then, fast forward, that was last Wednesday to this Monday. Our clinic has now been also closed because of just how worse everything's getting. Every day it's like, it's just not safe for our clients and for the students and just for everyone. It's just, you know, social distancing, it just makes sense to close the clinic, I guess. I'm not really sure what the details are, but I just know the clinic is closed. So yeah, it's pretty crazy. So as of right now, for my grad school, I'm basically just my online classes are starting this Friday, and I'm not sure what's going to happen with my clinical hours because we all still do need hours. You need a certain amount of hours to graduate, so this definitely interferes with that, but I'm just trying to stay positive. We should still be able to graduate on time and meet all of our requirements, so that's good news. Luckily, I'm really lucky in this respect that I only need about 9 more hours to meet my quota for this year for my hours. So I'm like, okay, like I could take a deep breath. 9 hours isn't that much. I could probably make that up next year, or I'm not sure if we're gonna do online hours. I know that that's a possibility. I'm not really sure anything that's going on right now. So I don't wanna, you know, give you guys, I don't really have any information. But yeah, it's just crazy because everything's changed. My life for the next 8 weeks is completely different. I went from going to school every day, 5 days a week, being at school for 6 to 9 hours a day, to now not having to be anywhere at all and having all my classes online and no longer having any clients or clinic. I guess I don't think I'll ever see my clients again. I'm not sure. So that's definitely sad, but it's all, you know, precautionary. I know that this is what needs to be done, and it's just, like I said, it's just a crazy time right now. So I really hope that everyone is okay and doing okay. I just hope everyone stays safe in this time and tries to find ways to find positivity and light and good in all of this. Spend time with your family, your friends, if you can, or FaceTime them. Maybe take up a new hobby, maybe do some yoga, read, meditate, watch your favorite movies, really good TV shows. I'm actually happy that I still have online class because I feel like I would go insane if I didn't have at least that, because I've basically been like self-quarantining myself just for, you know, social distancing, and where else am I gonna go? Everything around me is closed. I live in New York, by the way, for those of you that don't know, so they're really hunkering down here, and basically all the bars are closed, all restaurants are takeout only, movie theaters are closed. The only thing that's really open, to my knowledge, is supermarkets and like pharmacies and obviously like healthcare and doctor's offices and banks. So even if I wanted to go somewhere, which I don't, there wouldn't even be anywhere to go anyway. So I've basically just been under like self-quarantine for the past like 5 days, and it's making me go a little insane. I've actually been studying for my midterms, which are now online, so that's kind of been like grounding me and keeping my mind off of all this craziness. So I am grateful that I do have online classes to keep me sane and grounded and to at least feel like I'm working towards something and I'm still in school. The whole country is probably feeling this way right now, where like you would never have imagined your life to be like this. Like I should be in school right now. My whole trajectory for the next, you know, 2 months have changed, and it just is really anxiety provoking, and it just feels so weird. And it's like, oh, it's just like a weird feeling. So I'm grateful to have like school, although it's online, to distract me, and I'm just happy that I could still do distance learning and graduate still and get my education. So I'm grateful for that. I feel like that's all I have to update you guys on. Basically, like I said, doing online classes now, no clinic, not sure how we're gonna get our hours, that's still to be determined. Now that I don't have school, well, I do have school, it's online, but I will have so much more time to film videos, so I'm hoping to get a lot more videos out for you guys. Sorry that I haven't posted in a while. It's just been really hard with school. Like I said, this semester has kind of been a lot for me, just a little bit overwhelming. I'm at school 5 days a week. On the weekends, I'm doing homework. If I'm not doing homework, I'm just trying to stay sane and like sleep and maybe see some family and just like relax for my mental health. But now that I have a lot more time on my hands, a lot more, because I don't have to commute anymore, I don't have clinic anymore, I just have class, I have so much free time now. So I'm so excited to get back into filming more videos for you guys. I was actually gonna film like a vlog like a day in my life vlog for grad school, but I obviously can't do that anymore. But let me know any more videos you guys would like to see, and I'll definitely be posting more. Like I said, everyone, please stay safe and try to stay positive in this really hard time. I'm really thinking of anyone who's sick right now and dealing with this. You're in my thoughts. All I could say is we're all in this together, and we really need to come together right now and just unite and just all be thinking of each other. So subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye, guys.